Something I've been curiously looking into and observing for the past few months deals with the rise in depression and sadness amongst my generation, Gen Z. Loneliness, feelings of worthlessness, and self-harm have been trending upward throughout history. However, it seems that they have been increasing at a devastating rate amongst my generation, Gen Z, and the younger generation as well. The number of times I hear, or the amount of articles that I read about how younger people feel deep levels of hopelessness and despondency about their lives and the future of society is really a terrifying thing. I wanted to investigate this further to determine if the issue was really as problematic as I thought it was. As I was reading different articles, watching videos, and just listening to peers around me, I heard a variety of different answers and potential causes to this growing phenomenon. Depression, loneliness, emptiness, these are all adjectives some people would use to describe their current state of living. They're all difficult emotions to pinpoint a specific causation to, and to sum up another person's emotions into something so simple, it would be really dismissive and disrespectful to the real difficulties that people are experiencing. Something that I've been constantly annoyed by is people summing up this phenomenon of Gen Z's loneliness and depression due to the constant activity on social media and the internet. These half-assed arguments and quite inconsiderate arguments really go as follows. Gen Z is lonely because everything in their lives revolves around their phones, the internet, and social media. Gen Z is lonely because they are overstimulated. Their smartphones have given them access to so much, so often, that they can't help but to feel lonely just because they are used to having everything constantly all at once. Gen Z is lonely because they lack proper social skills. And yes, I'm pretty sure you guys can already bet what they blame Gen Z's lack of social skills on: social media and the internet. Although I do not completely agree with the oversimplification regarding Gen Z's loneliness and depression revolving around social media and the internet, for the sake of examination, I will address the argument and offer my opinion on this assertion. As I've said already, this argument is completely oversimplified, but there is some merit in what they are trying to say. Gen Z is a generation that has grown up with the internet. Our lives were already becoming extremely digitalized the moment we entered into the world. We have been conditioned to believe that our digital life is extremely important, and in many ways, they now are. If you are applying for jobs, many employers check your online profile to determine whether or not you are a worthy candidate to work for their company. If you are looking for someone to date, having an online profile either on a dating app or some sort of social media app, Snapchat, Instagram, TikTok, whatever, that's the way you do it. And really what makes me laugh the most about people who say these things is that they really believe that it's completely Gen Z's fault as to why so many of us are so encapsulated on the internet. Now, I am not blind to the reality. There are things that Gen Z can do to curb the feelings of loneliness if, you know, social media and the internet were really those root causes. Taking breaks from their phones, going outside, and interacting with people around them, taking up some sort of class, yoga, spin class, a martial art, maybe a outside sport, all of these things where they are engaged with other people in their daily lives, forming these kind of bonds and intimate connections, is a way to kind of combat those feelings of loneliness that many people may feel. The idea of just put down your phone is one that seems simple and effective as the one cure, you know, that's the best cure that people can come up with as far as Gen Z's problem. Even though just put down your phone, it seems simple, it seems like the most effective cure, what if it really isn't? The idea of taking internet breaks and putting down your phones is a concept that many people of Gen Z are well aware of. The lack of awareness amongst Gen Z isn't as poor as people make it out to be. They realize that their lives are highly digitalized. They realize that they have a richer and sweeter digital life compared to their personal lives. But what is the alternative for many of them? There is a vicious cycle that takes place in the minds of many young people. And it goes like this. Even if I wanted to get off the internet and social media and, you know, be outside and do more things in my daily life, what if I miss out on something? what will I talk to my friends about at school, at work, you know, in our personal lives, if I really don't know what's going on the internet? Because let's be real, that is the culture, that is the conversation. A lot of the conversations that take place amongst kids today are based off of the things that they experience online, whether it be when they're playing their games online, they're watching YouTube videos, they're watching some sort of TikToks, trends, these dances, whatever the case may be. A lot of the conversations that gets brought up revolve around what's taking place on the internet. So if you're encouraging someone to disassociate themselves with it and spend more time in their personal lives, spend more time engaging with their friends, a lot of them, it's counterintuitive to them in a lot of ways, because a lot of what interactions they have with their friends are based off of things that take place online. To you, that may seem immature, or they may seem like sentiments of a whiny child, but this is the reality for most younger people today. These are the things that go through their mind, and this is what keeps them glued to the internet. Still, I do believe there must be something said about Gen Z and their use of the internet. It still seems that they recognize their loneliness and potential causes for it. However, they still engage in a lot of self-destructive or self-sabotaging behavior that deepens the void that they feel inside. Not only does Gen Z participate in these self-destructive and self-sabotaging behaviors, but they seem to also be the biggest advocates for it as well. These trends that encourage people to be completely self-reliant, entitled, and uphold these ridiculous standards of living are what keeps many of these people feeling alone and worthless. Trends such as lazy girl jobs, main character, alpha males, and couch potatoes, and I'm sure there's a whole bunch of other ones that people create on a daily basis that I'm not even aware of. All of these people advocate to their fellow peers and even to younger people that you have certain needs, so go satisfy them. You have just as much right as anyone else, so don't hesitate to satisfy your needs. Actually, expand your needs and go out and demand more. Your standards should be through the roof. And no matter what, no matter who comes your way, doesn't matter if they treat you well, it doesn't matter if this opportunity is good for you, if it's not at this bar, if it's not above and beyond the stratosphere, if it's not at that level, then you should not accept anything less than that. They tell people all the time, and they get on camera, you, yes, you, random man over there, random guy watching this video, you are a king. You, random woman right here watching this video, you are a queen. So go satisfy your needs, go fulfill them, and accept nothing less than opulence and perfection. Do not settle for anything less than the best of the best. Why? Because you're entitled to it. This has become the worldly doctrine of today, and somehow we have convinced ourselves that this is happiness. However, the result hasn't been happiness. It's been an increase in the feelings of hopelessness, worthlessness, leading people into isolation, and eventually self-harm. This is where I agree with people highlighting the counterintuitiveness of social media. The power of technology should have allowed people to become much more connected than we were before. Yet, people are becoming more isolated than we were in the past. As someone who has participated and who still actively participates in the cycle of keeping people glued to the internet, I can't help but feel responsible for the direction that society is headed towards today. The difficulty I keep running into is that this issue is non-reversible. Technology will continue to advance, and more kids at a younger age will be conditioned to actively interact online. If we just think about history and how people interact with the internet, and at what age, it has become more accessible to younger people, easier to navigate, and cheaper to access, making the barrier to entry extremely low. It also doesn't help that there are parents out there who would rather not parent or avoid parenting by just sticking iPhones, iPads, and other sorts of technology in their children's faces at an extremely early age. Again, this doesn't contribute at all into remedying the growing issue that we're facing is not doing anything but exacerbating the issue. But again, as technology continues to advance, as it becomes more accessible, cheaper to access, I don't think any of those phenomenons are going to change at all. Now, self-harm has been an issue for a long time, but it seems to be increasing dramatically. Every time I scroll through my news feed, I see stories of some celebrity, company executive, and even everyday people committing self-harm. It does not help that I click on these stories and read them, because we all know how algorithms work to feed you more content that you want to see. But whenever I read these articles, it always involves a young person, someone in their 20s or 30s. Obviously, no, a person committing self-harm at any age is not okay, but it's always extremely hurtful to read about someone who hasn't had an opportunity to really live or experience their life yet, decided to take their own lives way too early because they felt extremely lonely, worthless, or hopeless in that moment. Quite honestly, I don't care what the reason is, social media or not, it is a sad phenomenon regardless of what the driver is. Not to make this video about me, but I've had moments of extremely dark and challenging times as well, and I still have plenty of those moments. I am aware, well aware, of how pressuring life can be. The feeling of underachieving, you know, you're not seeming to keep up with your peers, and so many other life stressors, it all starts to feel pointless. One day, you're having a hard time, and the next day, you feel a huge sense of accomplishment. Then the next day, you have the worst day of your life, you get hurt and frustrated, convinced that you can't go on living. But then you have a good night's rest, and you feel refreshed, ready to carry on with your life. All these ups and downs can be exhausting. Living really can be exhausting. Living feels like a burden, a drag to carry on with, and something that, honestly, at times you just would rather not do anymore. Although life can be exhausting with its constant ups and downs, self-inflicted homicide is not the answer. There's a lot of pressure to be a particular way, and with social media and the internet, many more voices are starting to give their opinions. So it really can be difficult for someone who is impressionable and trying to figure out their lives to understand which path to take. My reason for making this video was this. Despite how you might feel, or despite how others might make you feel, before you decide that there is no value in your life, before you decide to leave, I wanted to be the one to tell you to please stay, because no matter what struggles you've been through, no matter what traumas you're currently dealing with, no matter if you're not the beauty standard, I just wanted to be the one to tell you, no matter what, you still have something that you can contribute. Sometimes I